following program is brought to you in living color on NBC.
Everybody loves somebody sometimes. And a sky of blue above, both sunshine's bright, the world's all right, cause I'm in love. There's a rainbow round my shoulder, and it fits me like a glove. Let it blow and storm, I'll be warm, cause I'm in love. Hallelujah, how the folks will stare when they see the diamond solitaire. That my little sugar baby is going away. Yes, sir. There's a rainbow round my shoulder and a sky of blue above, and I'm shouting so the world will know that I'm in love.
Hallelujah, how the folks will stare when they see the diamond solitaire.
That my little sugar baby. The world will know that I'm, yes, I'm in love.
Well, he's finished. Good. Hey, I feel beautiful. Only last night I had a cold in my chest, so I got under my electric blanket, and this morning I felt fine. The ice cubes melted. Funny thing happened this morning. By mistake, I connected the TV set with the toaster. I was watching an Italian movie, and every time the toaster came up, Sophia Lorenz popped out of her dress. I also saw Mary Yordi on television. He's finally decided to do something about all the pollution and filth in the air. He's going to hire a woman to come in twice a week. And I saw where 36 hippies got hurt in a crash. Their bed caved in. I want to kill hippies. Don't jump on my car. Anyway, I'm glad I'm feeling better. I'm listening to my doctor now, and I even tried to give up cigarettes and smoke a pipe, but I couldn't get used to it. Every time I put my pipe out, I stepped on it. You know, I think you're going to enjoy our pipe tonight, our show tonight. We got some wonderful guests, and if you're a good audience, after the show, we'll all go over to Granny Clampett's house and count wrinkles.
Well, you know, they say that love is blind. It's also deaf and dumb and sometimes a little bit crazy, as Zero Mostel is just about to find out.
Oh, I love you, honey.
Oh, darling, I love you, too. Oh.
I love you, darling. I love you.
As much as I love you.
No, I love you more than you love me.
Oh, you could, darling.
Not, words can't say how much.
Oh, try, darling, try.
Okay, I'll try. You're an angel sent to me from heaven. I've never loved anyone till I loved you. But I'm not really worthy of your love. You're a princess.
Kiss me.
Of love, kiss me. And I can only say you're the dearest, most wonderful thing that ever happened to me.
Oh, darling, remember the first night we met.
Where was that?
That little sidewalk cafe with the wonderful violinist.
He played our song all evening.
Oh, I'd love to hear it again right now. Let's put the record on.
Okay, the record.
Zero Mostel, Jackie Vernon, and the Gold Diggers.
Here are four young ladies I'm always happy to have on my show. They're called the Ding-a-ling Sisters, and they can ring my chimes anytime they want. Ladies and gentlemen, the Ding-a-ling Sisters.
Y'all, come on in now. Right on down front. Got something I want to show you. Well, now you heard of the popcorn, and you heard of the dog, and you heard about old Europe. Well, now there's a brand new dance that's going around, and I want to show you all just exactly what I'm talking about. Well, now I'm talking about the funky chicken. You ready, girls?
Yeah.
All right. You put your left arm up and your right arm too. Let me tell you just what to do. Set your arms up a bit, then your feet start to go. Put both arms behind your back. But watch your set. Go really at it. Put your arms up a hill. And then your feet start again. Then you know. You're doing the funky chicken dance. Move it on down. Move it on down. Get it. Move it on down to me, baby. cruel or necessary. Hey, people, you know this is the kind of dance that makes you feel like you want to do something nasty. Hey, girls? Yeah, like spilling some chicken gravy all down your overalls. Right down the front. All right. Now you work both arms. Then you work both feet. Use the elevator.
My dog has fleas. A little out of tune. Give me an A, will you? Close enough.
Well, here I am, the proud bird with the golden tail.
You look more like a cockatoo with a gland condition.
Hey, don't make fun of these wings. I even wore them down on Earth.
Are you kidding?
It may have looked silly, but it kept me out of the army.
You must be the new trumpet player. Pull up a cloud and stand up.
Hey, do you know the head angel?
No, but if you hum a few bars, I'll fake the rest. Okay, so it's an old joke. You're so touchy.
Man, we must be a million miles up.
Yeah, ever been this high before?
Only when I was down there.
See that little speck down there? That's where you just came from.
That's Colucci's Bar and Grill.
That's the Earth.
Boy, I sure hated to leave it. Everything was so great down there.
Yeah, if everything's so great down there, then why is President Nixon building an ark?
I guess the big boss didn't like that either.
That wasn't him. That was Agnew. He hates criticism.
Hey, I'm supposed to audition today. Where's the rest of the band?
They should be back any moment now. They're out on a 5,000-year break. Hey, who'd you play with down on Earth?
I was with Les Brown and his band of renown.
Les Brown? Les Brown?
Yeah.
Les Brown.
Les Brown.
Les Brown. The Les Brown.
None of his guys ever made it up here before.
I guess Les won't give him time off. It sure is peaceful and calm around here.
Yeah. Nothing much ever happens around here.
I've never seen anything so quiet and dull before.
First time you've ever been in Burbank?
Hey, I got him on right. What are you playing? I know that one.
How I love the kisses of Dolores till I found out she was Morris.
That's pretty good. Ooh, I got a tickle on my nose. My buddy Ken here just joined Bachelors Anonymous. It's a great club. Whenever you feel like getting married, you call a member, and he sends over a woman in a torn bathrobe, curlers in her hair, and grease all over her face.
The sweetest sounds I've ever heard are have a drink on me.
Just stick that in. Ken? Yeah. I guess I'm gonna leave you now. Before I go, you think about this. You show me a man who is filthy rich, and I'll show you a wealthy hippie. Come and see in here.
Penny, my baby kid. I'm so worried about you.
Mama, what's the matter?
Oh, I've been so worried. I was up all night.
Mrs. Lane, why are you worried?
Who are you? Oh, yes, of course. You're that Italian boy, Marvin, who sings on my Kenny show. Kenny, I am so worried about you. Now that you're such a big star, a television show of his own, you'll be meeting a lot of girls, members of the opposite. The opposite?
Sex?
You're an animal.
What's the matter with the word sex?
Marvin, in front of Penny, we do not, and I repeat, not use four-letter words like S-E-dash-X. My baby, I've got to tell you the facts of life. I can't put it off any longer.
Why? Did somebody get his teddy bear in trouble? Mrs. Lane, you're going to tell him the facts of life here, right now?
It's better he hears it from me than he picks it up from people who hang around pianos.
Hey, he'll never hear anything from me. I come from a strict home. When all the other kids were playing doctor, I was playing dentist.
Robin, singers should be seen, not heard. To remember, dear, is love doesn't have to be cheap or rotten. No, love can be beautiful, except maybe with your father. See, Kenny, when two people are mutually attracted to each other, there's a whole chemical reaction.
Mrs. Lane.
I'm not now, Marvin. I'm rolling. A whole chemical reaction. Someday you're gonna meet a wonderful girl, heaven forbid. And you and that girl are gonna want to live together.
Oh, no, Ma. I just got my own room.
Your mother's right, Ken. There's a lot more exciting things in life than sneaking down to the A&P and sniffing cantaloupes.
Don't make sarcastic, Marvin. Remember the old saying, if you break a mother's heart, from this show you can depart. Now, what was it, Kenny? The facts of life are as follows. A boy and a girl meet. They fall in love. They get married. They leave the church, and that's when it happens.
What's that?
They go to visit his mother. Now, I don't want to be late for my chiropractor's appointment. But before I go, I want you to play that song that I love. And Marvin, cough, baby, if you want, you could sing. But remember that somebody might be listening.
Right. Climb upon my knees, sonny boy.
Does he play beautiful, huh? Believe me, it was worth every penny to have his fingers straightened.
Though you're only three, sonny boy.
You think he's good now. Just wait a few years till his feet reach the pedals.
You know we're no one there. No way of showing what you mean to me, sonny boy.
Not too loud, Marvin. Remember, you wouldn't even be on the show if Kenny didn't need a token Italian.
Friends may forsake me.
He looks so nice. It breaks my heart when I think someday his hair is gonna turn dark.
Let them all forsake me. I'll still have you, sonny boy.
Never mind the facts of life, Kenny. You should never use your hands for anything but the piano.
That is good advice your mother gave you, Ken.
Hey, now that she's gone, why don't we get up a wild party?
Good idea. You bring the birds and I'll get the bees. Anybody in the closet?
Okay, I'll take a look. Hi, Robert Wagner.
What is a pal of mine?
Thank you. Say, I just ran into a jewel thief who said that he had a ruby that he thought might belong to you.
Well, let me have a look.
Hey, Ruby.
Robert Wagner, boy. If that's Ruby, I think I'll have her made into a pair of cufflinks. Mr. Robert Wagner, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, what a thief. You gonna take her with you?
I can't show my face, can't go any place. People stop and stare, and it's so hard to bear. Everybody knows you left me. It's the talk of the town. Every time we meet, my heart skips a beat. We don't stop to speak, though it's been 1 week. Everybody knows you love me. It's the talk of the town. Sent out invitations to friends and relations, announcing our wedding day. Friends and relations gave congratulations. Can I face them? What can I say? Let's make up, sweetheart. We can't stay apart. Don't let foolish pride keep you from my side. How can a love like ours be ended? It's the talk of the town.
Hi, fun seekers. Welcome once again to Vernon's Viewing Room, where we present pictorial histories of famous people. Tonight, at Dean's behest, we shall be viewing slides depicting highlights of the career of the incomparable Zero Motel.
That's Mostel.
I'm glad you told me before I checked in. But first, Dean, let me say how much I've enjoyed tonight's show. I was literally doubled over.
You were laughing that hard?
No, my tie was caught in my zipper. But prithee, let us not tarry. Lights out, please. And now for the slides. Here you are, Zero, your first night on Broadway. And there's the street cleaner waking you up the next morning. Here you are with Helen Hayes in a dramatic role. Now here's you and Helen after you stop rolling there. Here you are at the theater starting one of your longest runs. Here you are finally reaching the restroom. And Zero, for your performance in Fiddler on the Roof, you received Broadway's highest honor. Here you are getting a Tony. Here you are taking the curlers out of your hair. End of Act One. Hey, Zero, can I have a handful of popcorn?
Sure.
Thank you. And now for our second feature. We present... Thank you. you. We present more memorable moments in the career of Dean Martin. Here you are, Dean, as a struggling young performer. Here you are, finally getting her into the back seat. Here you are, singing at your first affair. Here's your girlfriend telling you to shut up. Here's your first one-nighter. And here you are, seeing her the second night. Here's a shot of you I'm sure you'll remember. It's the first time you appeared nude in a movie. And of course, you know what this is.
Yeah, that's the usher throwing me out. You know, my next guest is not only a good pal of mine, but also one of the outstanding actors of our time. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Zero Mostel. Played just about every kind of role there is. Is there any one part you always wanted to play that you never got the chance to do?
Yes. I've always wanted to play Lady Macbeth.
Lady Macbeth?
I don't know, Dean. With a little lipstick, a little eyeshadow, a wig, who's to say I couldn't pass for an ugly broad?
Who's to say that?
It's not so far-fetched, Deansy. Really, it isn't. Back in Shakespeare time, an error that eludes you. All the female roles were acted by men.
Hey, Zero.
Hey, Deansy.
Why don't we show the folks what it was like back in Shakespeare's day when a guy auditioned to play the part of a girl?
All right. You be the director, and I will be the actor auditioning for the part.
An actor awaits. He is here to audition for the part of Ophelia.
Well, send him in, baby.
Well, odds bodkins, it's Mama Cass. What was all the yelling about, baby?
I left my hat on a chair and accidentally sat on it. I'm here to audition for the part of Ophelia.
Well, frankly, I was hoping for a younger man. As long as you're here, let me see your legs.
I'm sorry, I don't do cheesecake.
I'll bet you eat plenty of it, though.
Look, my good man, you must take into account that I'm not wearing the proper foundation.
Prithee, why not?
Not prithee, prithee.
Prithee, why not?
There are not many two stores carrying a size 52 body stocking. It's obvious that you don't care for this frock. What do you think I'd look good in?
Probably the Tower of London. Look, Mac, baby, have you ever played the part of Ophelia before?
No, but I recently played Lady Macbeth. In fact, I ad-libbed the famous line, "Out, out, damn spot." I was trying to get rid of a hickey at the time. Look, you hire me, and you won't regret it. I'm an excellent actress, and I love couch work.
Yeah? I can tell you're not just another pretty face.
My last show was a command performance for the greatest queen of them all, Queen Elizabeth. Have you ever played in front of a queen before?
Are you kidding? I had three screamers in the audience last night. Okay, you'll do. Hey, what's a nice kid like you doing in show business anyway?
I don't know. I guess it's because of the emotional experience, the artistic challenge, the aesthetic rewards. Besides, it's a good way to attract broads.
Up your Shakespeare, start quoting him now. Brush up your Shakespeare, and the women you will wow.
Just declaim a few lines from Othello,
I hear.
And they'll think you're a heck of a fellow.
If a blonde won't respond when you flatter her, tell her what Tony told Cleopatra. If her virtue at first she defends well, just remember that all's well that ends well.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Brush up your Shakespeare and they're all cow-town. Your Shakespeare, start quoting him now. Brush up your Shakespeare, and the women you will wow. Just recite an occasional sonnet, and your lap will have someone upon it.
If your girl is a Washington Heights dream, treat the kid to a Midsummer Night's Dream.
If she then wants an all by herself night, let her rest every 11th or 12th night.
Yeah, yeah, yeah,
brush up your Shakespeare, and they'll all kowtow.
How now?
And they'll all kowtow.
Oh, yeah!
And they'll all kowtow.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Zero Mostel. Zero, in all your Broadway shows, you not only proved you're a great actor and singer, but also that you're a very good dancer.
Well, you know, Dean, I love dancing. It's the only thing that keeps me in shape. If I gave up dancing, I'd blow up like a balloon.
Blow up like a balloon, huh? I guess Sophia Loren gave up dancing twice. Oh. Do you have any favorite number that you'd like to dance to?
Well, I've always wanted to do Me and My Shadow the way the great Ted Lewis used to do it. Oh,
sounds great. Well, why don't you do it for us now?
Dean, I'd love to, but I don't have a partner to play my shadow.
Hey, listen, we got the perfect guy to do it. Hey, Tommy! Tommy. Hi, Tommy. This is Tommy Toon.
Hello.
This is my shadow. 30 years in show business, and I wind up working with a Huckleberry Tipperello.
You think maybe he's too thin?
Too thin? My zipper's wider than he is.
Zero, give the kid a break. He's dying to work with you. Hey, Tommy, you're really impressed working with Zero Mostel, aren't you?
Oh, I sure am, Mr. Martin. He's got a zipper that's wider than me.
All right, thank you. We don't have any time for hero worship. No, look, I'll give you a couple of canes, okay?
Oh, fine, thank you. I'll just limber up, Mr. Mostel.
Think you can keep up with me, kid?
Oh, I'll sure try, Mr. Mostel. Can you do this?
Have you seen a doctor about that?
Thank you.
How do you like that? Even my cane went to pot.
But don't worry about it, Mr. Mostel. You've got a zipper that's wider than me.
Oh, shut up. Mr. Les Brown. If you please. Me and my shadow strolling down the avenue. Gracefully, kid, gracefully. Me and my shadow. Not a soul to tell my troubles to. Get a little twinkle in those toes, my boy. When it's 12 o'clock, we climb the stair. Nobody knocks, 'cause there's nobody there. And me. It's easy for you. You don't have a lot of keys in your pocket, rotten kid.
I do it myself.
Me and my shadow, all alone and feeling blue.
very funny guy with a wild approach to comedy. He's fresh, bright, and inventive. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Fred Smoot.
Thank you so very much, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to have the opportunity to take us back into history for a reenactment of a very significant time, the 1800s. The winning of the West and how it actually happened as Smoot views it. So hold on to your seats because here we go. There we are on a wagon train and Mose, the head wagon master, cracks the whip, making the team move out. And sitting up there in the buckboard next to him is his honey little wife, Mace, in the back of the wagon, its little small family of 10,000 kids. Ladies and gentlemen, the winning of the West such as you've never seen it before. Come on now, move out, yes! Come on, come on!
Oh, don't worry about it, Dad. This is so exciting, being pioneers and sitting up. Oh, why, look at the cute little white puffs of smoke over the foothills.
Cute white puffs of smoke? Glory be, woman, you know what that means. We gotta have the wagons go into a circle. Come on, men, swing it around.
Meanwhile, while they're doing this, 10,000 hippie Indians sitting up in the foothills observing all this. And the great chief of all the tribes.
White Fink. We give him shaft.
Meanwhile, the pioneers. All right, men, break out the Winchesters. Make sure every shot counts. Sam, take the women and children.
Man, what a bad place to get it. Oh, they got me, honey. I won't be making it to California with your girl. Take care of the kids and me.
Well, this has a rubber tip on it. It really looks grim, though. It really looks grim. The Indians have the pioneers surrounded. But who always shows up? Who always shows up in the last few crucial moments? 40,000 guys dressed in blue unis. The ROTC. Seventh Cavalry. All right, Bugler, sound the charge. What musician can blow on horseback at 70 miles an hour? But meanwhile, while this is taking place 100 miles away in a place called Dodge City, another great moment of history is occurring. At the other end of town, in a place called the Old Sage Bar and Saloon, standing up beside the bar, sipping a few drinks, is one of the meanest, toughest hombres of the Old West. He goes by the name of Frank Weed. There he is, looking at the bartender, chewing a little chewing tobacco like they always did back then, and sipping a whiskey sour.
Well, I'm sorry, lady, I didn't see you standing there.
All right, bartender, hit me again. Nice.
God, God, why'd you go do that for?
But meanwhile, in through the swinging doors of the Old Sage Bar and Saloon, the marshal makes his entrance.
All right, now listen here.
You talking to me, hombre?
There's nobody else in here.
Something tells me, hombre, you don't know who you're talking to.
Yes, I do. You're nothing but a meanie. You're responsible for stealing all the horses and piggies and lambs and chickies.
Is this some sort of a dad burn joke, hombre?
No, I'm furious.
All right, that did it, hombre. On the count of three, my hands are gonna go light and quick to my six guns.
Here it comes, hombre.
Uno! Duo! Trio, go for it and be mighty dad burn. Mighty!
Oh, now cool it. I forgot my guns again, dad. Hey, you ride your horse side saddle, don't you? I got a horse that goes side.
Come on now, come on with me, boy. Hey, want to have a little sarsaparilla or milk?
We've had a lot of letters asking whether the lady who plays Ken Lane's mother on our show really is his mother. Well, to be perfectly honest, she's not. She's really his uncle. But kidding aside, her name is Kay Medford. She's a wonderful lady and truly a fine actress. We'd like to feature her now with my good friend Zero Mostel in a number that Zero introduced in his Broadway smash, Fiddler on the Roof. It's about two people who've been married a long time and finally get around to asking each other a very important question.
Goldie, I've decided to give permission to marry for our daughter, Huddle.
What? But he's poor. He's got nothing. Absolutely nothing.
He's a good man, Goldie. I like him. What's more, Huddle likes him. She loves him. So what more can we do? It's a new world. A new world. Goldie. Do you love me?
Do I what?
Do you love me?
Do I love you?
Well?
With our daughters getting married, all the trouble in the town, you're upset, you're worn out, go inside, go lie down, maybe it's indigestion.
Goldie, I'm asking you a question.
What is it?
Do you love me?
You're a fool, you know that.
I know. But do you love me?
Do I love you?
Well, tell me.
For 25 years I've washed your clothes, cooked your meals, cleaned your house, given your children, milked the cow. After 25 years, let's not talk about love right now.
Goldie. The first time I met you was on our wedding day. I was scared.
I was shy.
I was nervous.
So was I.
But my father and my mother said we'd learn to love each other. And now I'm asking, Goldie. Do you love me?
I'm your wife.
I know. But do you love me?
Do I love him?
Let me hear the answer.
For 25 years I've lived with him, fought with him, starved with him. 25 years, my bed is his. If that's not love, what is?
Then you love me.
I suppose I do.
And I suppose I love you too. It doesn't change a thing, but even so, after 25 years, it's nice to welcome to my world.
Welcome to my world.
Won't you come on in?
Won't you come on in?
Miracles, I guess.
Miracles, I guess.
Still happen now and then. Welcome to my world. Leave your cares behind.
Leave your cares behind.
Welcome to the world.
Welcome to my world.
Built with you in mind.
If they
And the simple secret of the plot is just to tell them that I love you a lot. Then the world discovers as my book ends how to make
fun tonight, and I hope you enjoyed yourselves, too. I sure want to thank all my wonderful guests for being here, and I hope you'll all be watching next week. If you haven't got a color set, tell you what you do. Grind up a box of crayons and drop them in your picture tube. Good night.